Hola, Kinalito, aka Mahadi Selepe, the girl that calls four countries home. Welcome, welcome to my channel. I love you for being here. My subscribers, I love you guys. And even those of you that are not subscribed, but keep watching. I love you for watching. And I love you most if you comment on a regular basis. I see you. I see ya. I see ya. And I look forward to your comments. And if you're new here, welcome. And you can join this family by you know how. Okay, so today's video is a bit different. I'm going to react to a video that I watched. Anyway, she was reporting about a Instagram post. So anywho, I have got my ring light from my number one fan. Let us see. Can you guys see the difference though? I'm not quite seeing the difference. I guess because it's daylight, because I tried it on last night and baby honey, you could see the light. I mean, sort of there. Well, so the mic, I still do not know how it works, but I shall figure it out. So basically these are South African YouTubers, and majority of my viewers are South African, Lesotho. You know, you guys would know these people. So it's a post by, so I saw a post by Sims Wright. Okay, she's the Right Sims. I think she's the right Sims on Instagram. But I looked at her channel. It's actually called Sims Wright. So she does like entertainment, gossip, vlog, talks, and you know, just her life and stuff. So she's one of my favorite YouTubers. So she was mentioning, she said, I think it says y'all's left the sexy wives club, you know. And I thought okay, before I watch what she has to say, I'm gonna watch what y'all's says. So y'all's is another South African YouTuber. So I saw her post, you know, and I really loved her post. Like, I love all these YouTubers anyway. I really loved her post. She was talking about being true to herself. You know, that post inspired me so much. She turns 30 in a few months. She's so wise for her age. She was mentioning, like, she really inspired me, and I even left a comment there because I felt, yes, like I felt like she gave me permission to also do the same. You know, she mentioned how she's not true to herself. She's, since her father died in January or something, she has felt like, you know, while life is too short, life is also long, and we need to be true to ourselves and what we want. We need to not be apologetic by the choices we make for ourselves, even if they're not popular. Like, she mentions then that, you know, she's now able to say no to people, and she just feels she really does not have to explain herself. You know, if she's not up to something when she's asked, she's able to just decline, you know, humbly decline. And then she mentions a group of friends that she has taken herself out of because she just felt so out of place when she hung out with them. And I thought, wow, they're all really amazing women. You know, I follow them. She doesn't mention who she's talking about, but you know, the Right Sims or Sims Right, she mentions the group, and then that's when she mentions that she saw her. She actually mentioned it on Instagram. So she was doing, you know, how Instagram, you can say, ask me a question and whatever. And someone had asked, oh, what happened with you and the sexy wives? We didn't see you at the last meeting. because the Sexy Wives is a group of friends. It's just started by Mpumile Dwaba, which is another favorite YouTuber of mine. Very inspirational. There's a group of girls who are married, who hang out together. They just, you know, encourage each other and stuff, and then they share some of their experiences on their YouTube channels. I don't know if all of them are YouTubers, but the ones I know all are. So I think they probably all are. And I like that, what they do for each other, with each other, you know, and for us. I really like what they do, what they've created, what they, you know, that group of ladies, sisterhood thing going on. So anywho, Yol says she just felt out of place being part of that, and she took herself out, and you know, she just told them that, you know, she was just honest about how she felt, that she really feels awkward. So thank you, but no thanks. I thought, wow. I felt, wow, how powerful, because I have a similar situation, you know? Sometimes you love people, but you really, you're not gelling. You're really feeling out of place. And there's always that thing, at least with me, you know, I think naturally with a lot of people, you don't want to hurt people's feelings. You don't want to say hurtful things. You don't want to, you know, you don't know what to say, and you force yourself to be in these environments, in these sorts of companies that you really would rather not, where you have to work really hard to fit in, where you have to work really hard to enjoy yourself. You can't just be, you know. Sometimes you just feel like, I mean, I don't know exactly how she felt, why she felt that way, but, you know, just speaking on my own, you know, experience, sometimes you're in friendship groups where you are working so darn hard. You can feel that I do not fit. I'm not fitting here. I'm not the missing puzzle, and I really don't have to be friends with these people. They're very amazing people, but we don't have to be friends. We can be civil with each other. We can love each other from the distance. We can wish each other well, but we really don't have to hang out, because it's so hard. You know, sometimes you just feel like you are being criticized at every chance that people get. You are being put down. For what? You know? And then, for the sake of peace and, you know, to not make other people feel uncomfortable, you keep working at these relationships just so you don't rock the boat. But you don't need to. You don't need to. And it was so empowering just listening to yours. It was so empowering, freeing, that, yay, you know, it's so liberating that you can just walk away. You don't have to be part of this group. You can just tell them, look, it's really super awkward being in your presence. I think I won't be hanging out with you anymore. Like, I loved that, you know. I really loved that. The Right Sims reports on this, and then I see the comment section. Hey, people are so negative. People are like, yeah, this Sexy Wives thing, it's gonna end in tears, you'll see. This Sexy Wives thing, I never liked it. And me, I'm thinking, I love the Sexy Wives group. I love the ladies. I love all of them. Like, they're really amazing women. But I must say, since my own separation, I did wonder when I saw, you know, their latest post, I did wonder, wow. So what happens then if one of them, the marriage breaks down? So just like that, they get rejected because they're not a wife anymore. I did wonder. Then immediately I thought, anyway, we need to celebrate things as they're happening in their relevant state, because it doesn't matter. You know, we'll cross the bridge when we get to it. But I did wonder. I think for me, that would be my only reservation But having said that, I love forming groups and doing things like that, because already now I'm thinking, okay, I need to gather up all my single ladies, all my single moms, all my deserted ladies, you know, deserted and discarded. We need to support each other. We need to come together and remind each other that, hey, we are cool. There's nothing wrong with us, man. These men, it's their loss. It's their loss. We are it. We are the thing. We are enough. We are, hey, you know, because a lot of them, I just see people are just depressed. People are just depressed. Because it doesn't make sense. It makes no sense why your husband just wants to leave, you know, and they change. It's like personality transplant. People change, you know, and I'm not talking about my own husband. I was talking to someone last night. The husband has, people just change. The stories you hear, it's like it's a completely different person. I was watching Owami as well yesterday or the day before, talking about her own, you know, divorce proceedings, and she mentioned that someone said to her, if you want to see someone like how they really are, divorce them. Basically, if you want to know someone, you only get to know who your husband was when you're getting divorced, because of the nastiness that just happens. And yeah, it is not easy. It is not easy. But I really am for, I love support groups. I'm for support groups, man. I am all for support groups. So the sexy wives, I think the girls need to continue with what they're doing. It is amazing. It is an amazing ministry. It's good to be there for each other. I mean, we had lots of couples nights and things here in Perth once upon a time, you know, for many years. It sort of died down the last 3-4 years. It's probably died down because my husband and I were separated again 2015. We reconciled 2016. I think after that, we never had... Did we? Oh, yeah, I think we've had one here in the house. We have had one here. I wasn't the one who started it, but I loved it so much. I took it on like, you know, anybody could organize whenever. To have, okay, on such and such a day, ladies, can you have our husband come with your husband, let's have dinner together or something. Those are really, really good. But I felt the pinch in 2015 when they organized one and didn't even tell me because I was separated, you know. And at the time, I didn't see myself as not married, you know what I mean? Like, invite me. Let me decline and say, no, I'll be quite uncomfortable. Don't not invite me and we're friends and I don't even know about it until people come back that, we thought you'd, you know, we thought it would be an uncomfortable place for you. So I can just imagine the pain should, God forbid, anything happen with these ladies' marriages, with one of them. You just lose friends just like that because the friendship was based on the fact that you are married, you know. I think that's my only reservation. But like I say, I'm all for people having friendships that are based on similar interests, you know. So there's no winning, really. And I don't think it's going to end in tears. I really wish them well. I really love Mpumi's initiative. I love what they're doing. They need to thrive and keep doing them. And I also love y'all's stand and her prioritizing her and how she feels about that and not forcing herself to be part of something that she's feeling uncomfortable with. You know what I mean? So I love both camps. And I don't think, you know, she... They have not, they're not fighting about anything. Maybe there's something, because the people were saying on the comments of Sims Right that, one of them really gives me negative, I really get negative vibes with his wife's thing. And one of them mentioned one of them giving them negative vibes. Okay. So someone mentioned one of them gave them negative vibes, and someone mentioned the whole group giving them negative vibes. And I was thinking, me, I've only ever gotten positive vibes from that group. And from each of them. I think friendships are just complex. Friendships are complex. And it's interesting that, you know, me being 40, I'm dealing with those things. And I'm realizing now that people in their 50s are dealing with these things. People in their 60s are dealing with these things. People in their 70s are dealing with these things. So if you're a teenager or you're in your 20s and you're struggling with friendships, friendship drama, and you don't ever be impatient with yourself and feel like, or be impatient with other people. Feel like, guys, honestly, we're not in high school, you know, this, because it does sometimes get catty and feel like, goodness me, are we back in high school or something? We are people. I think as adults we become who we are in primary school. We are those people. We grow in certain aspects, but if you're a mean girl, that's just how you're gonna be even in your 70s. So nothing is gonna change. So things follow you. So people are the same. So as a result, you'll still have those challenges that you had in high school. But you, what you hope is people's maturity become better, and what you hope for is that you get a good group of ladies or men. I mean, I'm talking to the ladies anyway. What you hope is that you have a good group of ladies who have your back, whose back you've got. You know, I love my friends. I don't know if the age difference helps, you know. My other friend turns 51 and my other friend turns 49. Okay, those are my close friends. And then my other close friends are not here. They are my age, but they're back home. Good people, probably because we're so far away from each other. Also, that's what makes the friendship last. You know, we talk whenever we can. We don't talk all the time. We don't know each and everything that's happening, but we love each other. And whenever we meet or whenever we get to talk, we start from where we left off. I have another awesome friend. Hey, Tina. I have another awesome friend. I've never met her, and she's an incredible woman. I love her. She's in the UK. And she turns 40 as well this year, I think. Or was it last year? So, yeah, it is a blessing when you have good friends. It's a blessing when you get genuine people. Because it's a scarce thing. It is scarce to get genuine people, you know? So if you like yours, you're not feeling your people, you don't have to stay with them. You don't. Your peace is so important. Your peace is so important. Like, even for me, like, listening to yours, I was thinking, oh my goodness, you're speaking my language. Because right now, with everything I'm going through, my peace is number one. Number one. My peace. And like I've told you guys before, you know, I'm at such peace. I am at peace. And that's because, honestly, I've really kept the people closest that bring me peace. And the people that don't, they're not close to me. I love them, but they're not close to me because, you know. So it is very important when you're going through something significant, a significant life-changing experience, an event in your life, it is important to have to choose, be very, very, very jealous of your time and your space. Who are you letting into your circle? You know, who is in your inner circle? You know, there's a dot, you, and there's the family or inner circle. You know, you need to choose where you're gonna put people. Someone made this example for me and said, you know, you can't let the people in your outer circle. Oh, I remember who said that. You can't be as affected as, you can't let the people in your, who are so far away from your inner circle, to affect you as though they're in your inner circle. You know, when you hear anything they say or they do or they, you know, so you need to decide who's gonna be in your inner circle and gut that with your life. Be very, very, you know, territorial. Be jealous of your space and keep living. And also, if you're in a group of friends and, you know, people are criticizing you and whatever, just be true to yourselves. Love each other as friends, as a friendship group. Don't mind the naysayers, really. So, yeah, you know, I watched that and I thought, wow, how very interesting that from her report about y'all's leaving these girls, everybody now is talking about how negative that group is. And I just thought I'll come with a different thing. I didn't see anything positive on the events and on the comments. And I thought, okay, I'll just come with a positive feedback, you know, regarding the girls. Because I think it's good what they're doing. Like, I just love them, really. And I love yours. I love Sims. You know, she needs to keep giving us the gossip, you know. yeah. Anywho, be at peace with everyone. If you can, if you can't, walk away. Leave toxicity. Leave toxic people out of your life. They will eat away at you. You do not need that. Surround yourself with people that bring you life, that bring positive vibes, that build you. You know, people that you can build as well. People you can learn from. People who appreciate you, people who value you, you know. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. Love you, but remember that God loves you even more, and that is true. Ciao, ciao.
Hela, you watched everything. Thank you so much for watching everything. Now don't forget to subscribe and go back to my other videos and scroll and scroll and scroll and watch everything. There's very good things in here, very good interesting things. You are number one. Now thank you and take care of yourself.